Okay, I'm about to show you all how to fix a dryer. So, I washed my clothes and I tried to dry them 4 times. Now I'm getting really irritated, okay? So this is what I'm about to do. I'm about to get in the dryer. And you guys are freaking dying. Anyway, you vacuum out, I'm gonna show you this. You vacuum that out. You suck all this stuff out. You vacuum that out. Then you see this in here? See all that in there? You gotta get that out. So that's, so you're coming in the dryer with me. Get like a tweezer and do it. But after you get all of this stuff out the vent, so like guys, don't give up on your dryer before you try to do this, okay? Because this is the second time I've done this. So sorry about the echo, because I'm like totally in the freaking dryer. Anyway, get all this stuff out. And then I'm gonna get back to you and tell you how it worked. It should work. So I'm just over here minding my business, trying to fix my dryer. And all of a sudden we hear this big bang. Now you saw what happened. This man is frantic, all right? He's saying that supposedly a little boy was riding their bike across the street and he tried to stop and get out of the way for the little boy who was riding his bike. But mind you, it's like almost 10 o'clock, so all little boys should be in school. So I don't know if his story is correct, but let's investigate. I'm gonna show you. Thank God that the lady was inside, because she had a baby, a newborn baby, and he crashed into her car, which in turn made her car crash into another car, which the guy's out there. But this guy is like, he looked like he's about to have a straight up panic attack. Okay, I'm gonna show you now. I'm gonna show you. You see that? I don't want the cops to see me videoing them. Is that good? Man. That's terrible. I don't know what he was doing. He probably was texting. And that's his story. That gotta be his story. I can't. There ain't no little kids at this time. And if there was a little kid, there would have been an adult. Maybe it wasn't a little kid. Maybe it was like a teenager boy. That it would be a kid. But it pushed her into the thing. And then pushed her back into the other part. Crooked now. Alright, mommy ain't got no time for this. Okay? You're gonna see my kitchen. Look at my kitchen. Okay? I ain't got no time for this. I can't be up in nobody else's drama. Man is okay. The lady and the baby's okay. But my husband was about to go to work, so that's kind of scary. Like, he could have been crossing the street. Anyway, look at this. All right. So, I'm not... Okay. We vacuumed. I vacuumed it all out. I got a big, giant mess to clean now. Let's see if it's getting hot. Please be drying. It still doesn't feel warm enough. Maybe my dryer is really just... Look at all those clothes that need to be dried. Okay, I think they're drying. Anyway, so... if you ever feel like your dryer is not working and it's hitting the dump soon, make sure you go up in that junk. Take your vacuum and vacuum out all the little vents over there, because it could just be a simple clog. In my case, I don't really know, because I've had this for like 5 years and it's gonna go. I mean, they're gonna go. So there's only so much you can do. But FYI, you don't need a man. You could do it alone. All you single ladies, holla. I'm married, but you know, I just take things upon myself and I just, you know, just do it. So anyway, a woman can do a man's job if needed. So, that was the educational class for today. Thank you for joining. And now I must carry on with my cleaning. And got dishes to do. I'll be back when everything's nice and clean. Okay, all right. Have a great day. How cute is this? He's looking at her face. She's coming. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with you guys. After I took out all the lint from the dryer, it still was not working the way I needed it to work. It was drying a little bit more, so that lint needed to come out. But I'm like, why is this not working? It wasn't like feeling hot on the tube. So I stick my hand out because the way I have it, I have to put it out the window because in my apartment, my wash machine is hooked up to my sink. My dryer is hooked up to my stove connection. That's the way I work it, okay? Because I will be darned if I gotta go to the laundromat and do my clothes. No way, no how, especially when I have a washer and dryer. So my hubby figured it out for me. Anyway, he switched the piece so that it could fit into the thingy. So you could do that, okay? But anyway, so this is how I have to have it. It has to go out the window, all right? So this thing right here, the little hose, can you see it? You can't see it. The little hose that's connected for the vent was clogged from the plastic that was inside. So I figured that out because I'm like, okay, inside of the dryer was wet. I'm like, why is the inside of the dryer wet? So I had to put my thinking hat on and I figured it out. It must be clogged because there's nothing coming out of the hole and the clothes are still wet and the dryer inside is dripping. So that's what it was. So I uncleared it, moved around the plastic. Of course, it took a lot of work because then I'm stretching it and it's breaking and I had to like strap it up with tape a million times. But anyway, nonetheless, it's fixed. Yay! And now I can get back to doing my clothes.